Welcome to Utah State University's Vertebrate Paleontology course. My name is Benjamin Berger, and in this lecture, we will introduce you to some of the amazing fossil armored fish and other primitive jawed fish that lived during the Silurian and Devonian periods. One of the most characteristic prehistoric fish are the placoderms, a group of highly successful armored fish that lived during the Silurian and Devonian periods. These fish also were some of the largest fish, with estimated lengths of up to 7 meters. Placoderms are divided into 5 major groups: the Arthrodeer, the Ticlyodontidae, the Pelioicthyida, the Aniarcha, and the Renidia. Although there is evidence that as a group, these armored fish are a paraphyletic grouping, closely related to both jawless osteostrachthyans and chondrichthyans, such as sharks. The Arthrodeer group of placoderms are the most iconic of the armored fish. They include well-preserved Coccoosteus from Scotland, as well as the biggest fish of the Devonian, Ducliaosteus, from the Ohio in North America. Now, these fish exhibit an armored head composed of thick plates or scales. These placoderms exhibit a gap actually in the skull between the skull and the thoracic shield, which allows the head to move up and down while also exhibiting a strong jaw joint. Now, this arrangement provided a very quick motion for both opening and closing the jaw and allowing a really strong bite. These fish were active predators who fed on any fish, whether they were armored or not. The Arthrodeers also exhibited live birth rather than having eggs, a feature found in some sharks and bony fish. The next group are the Pelioicthyida, a less diverse group of fish that lived during the Devonian. With their low, wide heads and eye sockets opening upward, these fish are thought to be benthic living, swimming near the ocean floor. The Ticlyodontid are well known primarily from their tooth plates. Now, these less armored fish exhibit claspers in male individuals. Claspers are a feature seen in chondrichthyans, such as sharks. They're used for internal fertilization of eggs in females. These claspers are believed to have maybe arose independently than those found in sharks, but there are other similarities between placoderms and sharks to suggest a close relationship between the two groups. The Renidia are very ray-like placoderms with large pectoral fins and a very flat body plan. These are known from the Middle to Late Devonian and may have occupied the same niches as modern rays do today. The last group are the Aniarchaea, one of the most successful groups of placoderm fish living during the Devonian. These fish are weird in having armored their pectoral fins, which are encased in bony plates, a little like armor found in medieval knights. The top of the head was covered in 2 dorsal plates with eyes positioned close together. One of the most well-known Aniarchaean fish is Botholepis, which is known from the well-preserved fossils from New York and have been found from many Devonian sites around the world. Aside from these armored placoderm fish, there was an array of other early jawed fish, most of which are closely related to modern sharks. The first chondrichthyans, Cladoslechia, is known from the early Devonian, which closely resembles a modern shark. The skeleton was made out of cartilage and features a large pectoral fin. The fossil is an impression, since only the teeth and scales of these less armored fish survive fossilization. After the Devonian, the chondrichthyans, sharks, rays, and chimerids really started to diversify, and we will talk about their evolution later on. Now, during the Devonian, there was another group of early fish which lacked armor, the numerous acanthodian fish. These are also known as the spiny skins. Now, there's considerable debate right now over the relationship between acanthodian fish with both chondrichthyans as well as the bony fish, osteichthyes. Some researchers place the spiny skins in with the chondrichthyans, while others place some of the spiny skin fish within the bony fish. Now, there are a couple of interesting features in spiny skins that make them more advanced than fish we've seen before. Acanthodians have a scapular coracoid, which is a bone that supports the pectoral fin spine. The group show a diversity of fin spines that protect them from predators, but allow them to be more nimble and quicker at swimming than the armored placoderm fish. The gills themselves have gill rakes, a stiff support that is found in bony fish, another more advanced feature, although the cartilaginous neurocranium shares features with chondrichthyans like sharks. Now, all of these primitive fish lack a well-ossified endoskeleton. Much of what we know from these fish come from either soft body impressions, scales, including dermal plates, and teeth and tooth plates. During the Devonian, we also saw the rise of the first bony fish, which we'll discuss in the next lecture. All right, be sure to outline the characteristics of the major groups of primitive fish living during the early Paleozoic, including placoderms, the primitive chondrichthyes cladoseuchia, and the acanthodians, the spiny skins. Thank you for watching. If you would like to learn more about Utah State University's geology program, check out the website geology.usu.edu or my own personal website at benjamin/berger.org. Links are found in the description below.